Hello, my dear students. Welcome to 5th standard. Very good morning, my dear students. I hope you are fine and safe at home. In the last class, we have learned about the circulatory system. Shall we recall the lesson by listening the song? Okay, children, let us enjoy the song.
Dealing with all things vascular and cardiac.
Capillaries are the reason veins are the same. Circulation is the name of the game.
Taking blood from the heart to the cells and back. Dealing with all things vascular and cardiac.
Capillaries are the reason veins are the same. Circulation is the name of the game. Start from the heart, cause that seems smart. It's not hard to see that is the most important part. The first step is to gather up oxygen. Sends blood to the lungs, back to the heart again. And now the oxygen's gone, but first we got some carbon dioxide waste to take on, and it's into the vein and back to the heart again, and let the whole cycle start again.
Taking blood from the heart to the cells and back, dealing with all things vascular and cardiac.
Capillaries are the reason, veins are the same. Circulation is the name of the game.
Taking blood from the heart to the cells and back, dealing with all things vascular and cardiac.
Capillaries are the reason, veins are the same.
To the cells and back, dealing with all things vascular and cardiac.
Are you enjoyed the song, children? Okay, children. Today we are going to see about excretory system and nervous system. First, we are going to see about excretory system. Excretory system removes the waste product from the body. It also regulates water and electricity balance. Kidney, lungs, liver and skin together functions as excretory organs. This excretory system consists of the following. First one is kidney. Second one is ureters. Third one is urinary bladder. First, we are going to see about kidneys. The kidneys filter the blood to remove the waste and produce urine. The kidney are a pair of dark red bean-shaped organs placed between the abdomen on either side of the vertebral column. The average adult kidney measures about 12 cm in length, 6 cm in width and 3 cm in the thickness. A right kidney is slightly lower than the left kidney. Each kidney is covered by a fibrous membrane called capsule. These kidneys are made up of millions of excretory units. That is called as nephron. What is that, children? Nephron. The kidneys are made up of millions of excretory units called nephron. N-E-B-H-R-O-N-S. Nephrons. Which are the structural and functional unit of the kidney? So, functional unit of kidney means nephron. And then next we move on to ureters. We have these two ureters connect the kidneys with the urinary bladder. The urine formed from each kidney reaches urinary bladder through ureters. Next, urinary bladder. It is a sac like a shape and act as a temporary storage organ of urine. Urine entering the urinary bladder from the ureter slowly fill the hollow space inside the bladder. Urine is expelled from the body through the urethra. And then, do you know, children, every minute kidney receive approximately 1.250 liter of blood. One more time I'll say, listen children, every minute kidney receives approximately 1.250 liters of blood. So excrete, now you understand children, excretory system. Our excretory system is made up of three types: kidney, ureter and urinary bladder. We have two types, two bean shaped kidneys. And then functional unit of kidney is nephron. And then kidney receive approximately dash liter of blood, 1.25 liter of blood. Okay children, next we move on to nervous system. Our nervous system is on integration of nerves and specialized cell called neurons. In before excretory system, what we learned, functions of the kidney is nephron. Here nervous system is on integration of nerves and specialized cells are called neurons. So the human nervous system is divided into two types. First one is central nervous system. Second one is peripheral nervous system. Okay children, one by one we'll see. First one, central nervous system. Central nervous system consists of the following parts. First one, brain. Second one, spinal cord. Third one, nerves. Let me move on to brain. Okay children, we'll see now brain. We use our brain to think, read and write. The brain is covered by three membranes called meninges. These are dura mater, arachnoid membrane and biomater. The brain is kept in a bony case called cranium or skull. Already we know that children, our brain is covered with a thick pall that is called as cranium or skull. In the previous year you learned, correct? Yes children. It is made up of 8 immovable bones. The brain is made up of millions of functional unit called neurons. So functional unit of brain is neuron, neurons. Neurons. Our human brain is divided into three major parts. First one is forebrain, another word is cerebrum. Next one, midbrain, another word is cerebellum. Last one is hindbrain, another word is medulla oblongata. First we'll see forebrain, that means cerebrum. The forebrain consists of cerebrum, thalamus and hypothalamus. This forebrain consists three parts. First one is cerebrum, thalamus and hypothalamus. It is the largest part of the brain. And then it is the center of the human memory. And also it is responsible for intelligence, imagination and reasoning. Next one, midbrain, that means cerebellum. It lies behind the cerebrum, that means it lies behind the forebrain. It coordinates the movements of muscles of body. It helps to maintain the balance of the body. So next one is hindbrain, that means medulla oblongata. It behind hindbrain compress of bones and medulla oblongata. It is also called as brain stem. It is also called as brain stem. It is called vital node because it controls breathing, heartbeat, and other involuntary muscles. It connects the brain to the spinal cord. And then, very important children, average weight of the human brain is 1.3 kg. Average weight of the human brain is 1.3 kg. And then, our brain need continuous supply of oxygen for better function, correct? And then the brain loses the ability to function when it does not get oxygen for more than 4 minutes. Enough sleep and healthy food increase the efficiency of our brain. Okay, children, next one, spinal cord. First we saw brain, next one is spinal cord. Spinal cord is along a tube-like structure which extends from the brain. It lies within the backbone of our body. Okay, now we saw central nervous system. Next, we move on to peripheral nervous system. Peripheral nervous system consists of nerves extending from the spinal cord to all parts of the body. It is made up of two parts. First one is somatic nervous system. Second one is autonomous nervous system. This somatic nervous system carries sensation from the organs to the brain and take messages from the brain to the organs for movements. Then autonomous nervous system control the nerves of inner organs of the body. Now you understand, children? So we have seen in this session itself excretory system and nervous system. Our excretory system consists of three types, right? Kidney, ureters, and urinary bladder. And then how many kidneys we have? Two kidneys. And what shape? Bean shaped. And then functional unit of the kidney is nephron. And then in every minute, kidney receives how many liters of blood? 1.250 liters of blood. Next we saw nervous system. A nervous system consists of central nervous system, peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system can divide into three major parts: forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain. Thank you, children. We will meet next class.